what are the process of thermodynamics? Process of thermodynamics. So here, we'll be having first of this constant volume process. Second one is constant pressure process. Third one is constant temperature, constant temperature, and fourth one is adiabatic. So we shall take one by one. So first we need constant volume process. So constant volume. So this constant volume, how to represent constant volume in PV diagram? So that we will see. The constant volume in PV diagram. Pressure and volume diagram. So volume is remains constant and pressure is increasing. So we take it as a vertical line. 1 and 2. So here V is equal to constant. If V is equal to constant, I can write this P by T is equal to constant. Okay, so this is about the constant volume process. Similarly, if you want to take constant pressure, how to represent constant pressure in PV diagram? If you want to represent constant pressure, PV, here we take it as a horizontal line. Means volume is increasing or decreasing, the pressure remains constant. If pressure is constant, you can represent this V by T is equal to constant. So similarly, take a third one, constant temperature process. So constant temperature process, you can take PV is a curve. So this is PV is equal to constant. Okay, so moving 1, 2 is a compression. PV is equal to constant. So PV is equal to constant. Okay. So what about third one? So last one is adiabatic process. See, there is a one more word for adiabatic process. It's also called as isentropic process. Isentropic process. If adiabatic process means that heat transfer is zero, if heat transfer is zero, then entropy is constant. Okay, so this is how to represent a PV diagram. So here you can represent this P is also a curve, 1, 2, it is a compression curve. You can represent this PV over gamma is equal to constant. So this gamma is called as adiabatic constant. Here it is PV over gamma is equal to constant. So similarly, let the last fifth one is this is adiabatic. So last, the fifth one is polytropic process. So polytropic process, we take P over N is equal to constant. N value is a polytropic constant and gamma is an adiabatic constant. So these are the five processes are there in the thermodynamics. Okay, so next we'll go for thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics. So what is the first law? So first law is saying that algebraic sum of work transfer is equal to algebraic sum of heat transfer. So you can take integral of dq is equal to integral of dw. So here you get Q 1 to 2 is equal to delta V plus W 1 to 2. Okay. So after this we'll go for specific heat. Specific heat. So this is one of the important concept. Specific heat. What is the definition of specific heat? Okay, it is a capacity. No, specific heat is also called as it is having a heat carrying capacity. It is having heat carrying capacity, and here we will be having two types. One is specific heat and constant. Specific heat at constant pressure, specific heat at constant pressure, and second one is specific heat at constant volume. Specific heat at constant volume. So definition of specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume is, it is a amount of heat is, you know, amount of heat is, it is a dQ by dT. So dQ by dT means, you know, amount of heat is required to rise is unique, you know, temperature, what 1 degree of Celsius. Okay, it is at every place at constant pressure. Similarly, dQ by dT is every place at constant value. Okay, so amount of heat is required to rise at 1 degree Celsius or 1 unit degree, unit temperature degree Celsius. So it is a dQ by dT, T is equal to constant, dQ by dT, V is equal to constant. So this is Cp and this is Cv. Okay, so by using this, we have to understand. So what is the, you know, how Cp is related to enthalpy, how Cp is related to internal energy. That we have to derive it now. Okay, so if you want to derive how Cp is related to enthalpy and how Cp is related to internal energy, so we should know that. So enthalpy, what is the enthalpy? Enthalpy is the product of pressure and volume, product of pressure and volume less internal energy. Okay, so product of pressure and volume less internal energy. So this enthalpy we can know, we can define now how Cp is related to. Okay, so specific definition. So what is the definition of specific? So definition of specific is amount of heat is required to rise temperature by of a gas by 1 degree Celsius. Okay, so the specific heat we two types. One is specific heat at constant pressure. Constant pressure. Second one is specific heat at constant volume. So specific definition is amount of heat is required to rise temperature by unit mass of the gas by 1 degree Celsius. So Cp is equal to delta Q by delta T at T is equal to constant. This is the Cp. Okay. Similarly, Cv. Cv is delta Q by delta T at V is equal to constant. So this is the Cp. Okay. So now we'll see how Cp is related to enthalpy, how Cv is related to internal energy. So we'll take first Cp, constant pressure. See, from first law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, Q 1 to 2 is equal to delta E plus W 1 to 2. Okay, if P is equal to constant, then again W is equal to P dV. Okay, so W P dV 1 to 2. Okay, so we can substitute here. So therefore, Q 1 to 2 is equal to delta E means, you can take RLC to take dQ. Okay, so dQ dE plus dW. So dW means you can take 1 to 2 PdV. Okay, so now PdV. So then you can go and integrate this. If you integrate Q 1 to 2, okay, delta E means you can take E1 minus E2, okay, plus, or you can take E2 minus E1 plus E is equal to constant E2 minus E1. So you can take, you know, write like this, E equal to plus P V2 minus P V1. Okay, so you can rearrange this, P V2 plus E2 minus P V1 plus E1. Okay, so this is Q 1 2. Okay, what is P V2 and E2? P V2 plus E2, P V1 or E1. So here E is internal energy. So here one more definition is H. H means enthalpy. Enthalpy. So enthalpy definition is a product of pressure into volume plus internal energy. So you can write E R U. U R E is the internal energy. So enthalpy is equal to V plus U. Okay. So I am relating this V plus U here. So therefore, Q plus E. No, P, V, E, R, E, both are same. So if you take P, V2 plus E is what? U2. Okay, simple, sorry. H2, enthalpy 2. Here P, V1 plus E1 is an enthalpy matter. So Q12 is what? H2 minus H1. R you can write as DH. R you can write as DH. So therefore, so Cp is equal to del Q by del T. Del Q by del T will be equal to 1 step. So now Q is equal to H2 minus H1 bar, which is equal to DH. You can substitute here DH by DT. Okay. So therefore, enthalpy H is equal to Cp into DT. Okay. So if you want mass, you can take here capital H. Okay. So therefore, H is equal to mCp delta T. Okay. So this is how Cp is related to in enthalpy. Okay. So now we'll see what concept of Cv. Now we can go for saying now Cv is how related with the internal energy. So see here, similarly from first law of thermodynamics, you can take Q quantity is equal to delta T plus W quantity. So if the volume is equal to constant, W quantity is equal to 0. Okay, W quantity is equal to 0. So that we get Q quantity is equal to delta E or delta Q. So now we get Cv is equal to dq by dt, v is equal to constant, which is also is equal to w by del t. So therefore, u is equal to mcv dt. So this is how internal energy is related to the specific volume, specific volume. Okay, and then internal, you know, enthalpy is how related to the specific heated constant pressure. Okay, so now let us go to the next question is let us go to ideal gas and ideal gas. Therefore, Cp minus Cv is equal to 1. So it is a gas constant. Okay, Cp is constant pressure equation, Cv is constant volume. So R. So therefore, now another equation is gamma. Gamma means adiabatic constant is also equal to Cp by Cv. Okay, so now, okay. Next is, if you want to write R by Cv expression, or if you want to write R by Cv expression, so you can take Cv is R, so you get Cv by Cv minus 1 is equal to R. So Cv by Cv is gamma minus 1 is equal to R by Cv. So this is our R by Cv expression. So similarly, if you want to write R by Cp expression. Okay, if you want to write R by Cp expression, so you can take Cp is common, you get R minus Cp by Cp is equal to R. Okay, so then 1 minus 1 by gamma is equal to R by Cp. So therefore, R by Cp is equal to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So these are the two relations are very much required for derivations. Okay, so next, now these are the relations we required for our next derivations in applied thermodynamics, like water cycle or diesel cycle or Duggan cycle. What to do? We are going to get these derivations. Okay, so we need to derive a relation between volume, pressure, and temperature. So for deriving this, I take adiabatic process. So adiabatic process is PV over gamma is equal to 1. So first I will derive pressure and volume relation. So I will take P1 gamma is equal to P2 gamma. So P1 is equal to P1 by V2 power gamma. So first relation, pressure and volume. Next I will take temperature and volume. So for temperature and volume, I take PV over gamma is equal to. So to derive temperature and volume, we need to make it pressure. So therefore, we are going to use PV is equal to M1. So here I will not take mass Okay, a lot like mass in bar, so therefore we'll get P is equal to MRT by V. So P is equal to MRT by V. So here I'll substitute in the place of P. So in place of P, I'll substitute MRT by V and V over gamma is equal to constant. Okay, so therefore I'll neglect MR. Okay, MR is constant or neglect. So T. So therefore we'll get, so T by V is equal to V power gamma is equal to constant. So therefore T into V power minus 1 gamma is equal to constant. I think V in the numerator, so get V power gamma, no, power 1. So therefore T is equal to V power gamma minus 1. T into V power gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. Therefore if you want to write it for two condition, so T by V by gamma minus 1 is equal to T into V to. So I take T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 gamma minus 1. So this is the relation between temperature and volume. This is the relation between pressure and volume. So we go for next relation, pressure and temperature. So the pressure and volume is over, temperature and volume is over. Next we go for pressure and temperature. So therefore pressure and temperature, I take again T power gamma is equal to constant. So PV is equal to MRT. So I wanted to take pressure and temperature, I need to neglect volume. So to neglect volume, V is equal to MRT divided by P. So I neglect mass and constant. So it's up to therefore P is P into V power gamma. So in case of V, it gets up to T by P. So T power gamma divided by P power gamma is equal to constant. Okay, so P into, we will take it into the numerator. So P power minus gamma, so T power gamma is equal to constant. So if it 1 minus gamma, T power gamma is equal to constant. If you write it for two condition, P power 1 minus gamma, T 1 power gamma is equal to P 2 1 minus gamma, T 2 gamma. Okay, so therefore you wanted to write it for P, you know, P 2 by P 1 power 1 minus gamma, which is equal to T2 by T1 power gamma. So you want T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1, then T1 by T2, T2 by, now you want T1 by T2 is equal to, you get P2 by P1 gamma by 1 minus gamma. Or you can rewrite this, T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is the expression of temperature and pressure relation. P2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 gamma minus 1 by gamma. So these are the three important relations we required for problem solving. What are the rules? One is P2 by P1 is equal to P1 by V2 power gamma. Next, second one is T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 gamma minus 1. Third is T2 by T1 is equal to V2 by V1 gamma minus 1 by gamma. So these are the three relations are required for